brewed in the lands of
I feel like trying this one.
We may speak as peers, you and I.
Oh, I am so glad to find another of royal blood. I am so tired of sitting here all the time, but whenever I leave, thralls and lesser folk plant their fundaments on the great throne, and that's just not acceptable. I know you'll mind the proprieties and not let anyone else sit on the throne. And now, I'll finally be able to go and get some rest.
Oh, he's getting up and leaving. He went that way. Okay.
Perhaps we should look around more, Captain.
This situation calls for a good...
Sit on a chair?
An uncomfortable chair.
It's not a very comfortable chair to sit in, Captain.
Watch out, Lieutenant. Remember, uneasy lies the head that wears the crown.
I don't think Shakespeare had in mind a madman with delusions of grandeur, Doctor. Particularly since he was writing of his own Queen Elizabeth's ancestor, Henry IV.
Hmm. Have a seat.
This chair is a great way to set off an attack of sciatica, Jim.
Mm-hmm. Walked all the way over there just to say that. Spock's turn.
Very interesting, Captain. Except insofar as the individual was willing to sacrifice comfort for these rather doubtful additions.
Hmm.
Statistically speaking,
can't mind meld there?
I do not see the logic in that action.
What an uncomfortable chair.
Oh, is this some insignificant...
What an uncomfortable chair.
Is there some significance to this vegetation, gentlemen? Or captain?
What an uncomfortable chair.
Yeah, captain, should say.
What an uncomfortable chair.
A piece of red cloth, Captain.
Oh, he's analyzing it.
Bound paper.
Although evidently an adult, Jake C.
My blocks. Nice blocks.
Alright, let's... Can we get this?
I don't see how these can help us, Captain.
Well, you never know.
You can shift the big chair slightly, but you cannot pick it up and carry it. No effect. No effect.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
You want this thing?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Can we get these books?
I don't see how these can help us, Captain.
Stop blocking me. I think we're done then.
Save new game. Replace pre-
The king went this way. Oh. We never tried talking to these guys.
I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. What's going on here? Who's in charge?
Nobody's really in charge. Maybe the phase. That's one of the things that makes me so nervous. Nobody's really in charge. I try to take charge of little things, like making sure the lights work. I don't like the dark. Are you gonna be in charge now? Maybe you should talk to the phase first.
The phase? What's the phase? Why don't you just tell me what's going on here? If you need help, the Federation has many resources. Would you tell me about this ship? Why are you going to land in a town on Antipas? Why didn't you respond to our hail?
He probably doesn't know the answer to this, but I like all these.
Phase? What's the phase?
We contemplate our phase. Some of our people think they're the ones who keep everything going. Sometimes they tell us things to do. They remind some people when to eat. Otherwise, they'd forget. I don't forget, but that's because I'm smart. If you want to, you can probably talk to the phase in the oratory. The builders built the oratory. The room there to the south, they built the garden north. If you're hungry or if your head ain't feeling right, there's food and such in the hall. Through there, the west door. The rest hall is through the east door, but you might have to wait for one of the beds. The builders were just so logical. They, They thought of everything. You can go anywhere.
You know, Jim, I don't think there's much more he can tell us. I can take a tricorder reading on him if you think it's appropriate.
We've already done that.
Go away. I'm busy. My table must be kept clean.
You get no response from the youth. He glances up swiftly, then returns to his careful study of the tabletop.
Go away. You'll get it dirty. I can't stand a dirty table.
Apparently not. Can we smudge it?
Get away from my table! You'll get it dirty!
Freaking out.
I didn't know you had a green thumb, Jim.
I'm from Iowa.
I didn't know you had a...
I'm from Iowa, Bones. We've been farmers for centuries.
I didn't know you had a green...
I'm from Iowa.
Okay, okay. What kind of books do we have here?
Rexala Jat Methodinga Watamanana Jagarok Nu Ditiava Marinki Jawakabalam Kenawa Tromaman Ionomaskala Erjoro. I think our universal translator needs a bit more work on the phonetic system.
I believe it has found the proper lexicon. Try it again.
Big tailed baby antelope stew.
Oh my.
High temperatures badly burn the red wine sauce, so carefully watch the stewing juice at least 5 times in the cooking cycle.
That's fine.
Nice table.
The chair is reasonably comfortable. He glances up swiftly, then returns to his careful study of the tabletop.
Go away!
I don't think I can do anything for him, Jim. I'm not even sure there's anything particularly wrong with him. He appears to be anxious. But not so much that I feel chemical intervention is appropriate.
A scream.
Get away from my table! You'll get it dirty!
Nah.
Gardening is definitely not my field, Jim.
What do you think of the cookbooks?
Rexala Jout. Mathinga Watamana.
Watamana.
These new translation programs seem to take forever.
They're a lot more accurate, Bones.
The translation's complete. Well, what do you know? It's a recipe. Anyone for stewed antelope?
Why would they have antelope on their world?
Gardening is definitely not... I don't understand any of this, Jim. It would feel good to get off my feet for a minute, but we've got work to do, Jim.
A charming plant, Captain.
Are they all charming?
A charming plant, Captain.
The nervous youngster flinches away.
You are of the dark, are you?
Dark?
But you can't hurt me.
That's racist.
Not while the lights are on. I'm not afraid of you. I'm not.
He glances up swiftly.
Go away! You're breathing on my table.
Nah.
What exactly did you have in mind, Captain?
Just want to hear him scream again.
What exactly? This culture must have had a sense of aesthetics similar to ours, Captain.
How would you like some antelope?
My translator needs a little more time. It's a recipe for cooking stewed antelope.
I like the tone of voice she had there. That was funny.
What an uncomfortable chair. What an uncomfortable chair.
I got the wrong thing playing.
What an uncomfortable chair.
Captain, I do not understand the logic in that course of action.
He glances up swiftly.
Go away!
This table looks quite sturdy.
Given what we've seen of the inhabitants of this ship, it would have to be.
He's analyzing it.
I find the situation in this room disturbingly irrational at first impression, Captain. I suggest we endeavor to understand what we see around us in order to make a sensible analysis.
That's not what was written there.
He glances up swiftly.
Go away!
Go ahead, scream at Spock.
Get away from my table! You'll get it dirty!
I don't know why I find that so funny. Okay,
Save new game. Replace.
Can't think of anything else to do.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Captain, I do not think the plant is compatible with that container.
Can one of the others be compatible?
Captain, I do not think the... Captain, I do not think...
Okay, none of the ones in this room. Oh, do I have Spock look at the books? I don't think so. The stewed antelope thing is pretty funny.
It appears to be a recipe for cooking baby antelopes.
Baby ones,
aww. Or at least the closest animal to antelopes known to the parent culture.
No, he didn't have to wait for his translator. Alright, let's go through here. Some kind of cafeteria or something? Oh, there's the king. And where do we have the danger music playing?
Captain Kirk is not impressed with the housekeeping skills of the people living in this room. Bones thinks the youngster probably needs to get out more. The wise-looking Vulcan raises an eyebrow. The alert lieutenant thinks those living here have made at least half-hearted attempts to put their personal stamp on their living space. Difficult, starting from institutionalized beginnings.
Indeed, huh?
A youngster is sitting alone, quietly playing.
Looks like he's just rocking.
This elderly individual lies on a bed, his eyes closed in sleep. He clutches a blue blanket tightly around him.
That's a green blanket.
This elderly... Captain Kirk is not impressed with... Captain Kirk is... A simple sliding door of reasonable dimensions for a person to walk through.
Is there nothing to look at besides...
A simple...
Guess not.
A sleeper ship. Is there a more primitive way to achieve star travel?
There are generation ships, Captain. Although I hesitate to engage in speculation, these people might have been the descendants of the original passengers.
True.
Not the passengers themselves.
Given what I've seen, Spock, I don't think they'd survive as a generation ship. I'm surprised they've survived as long as they have.
An astute observation, Doctor. I am impressed.
As much as I hate to break up this newly formed Mutual Admiration Society, we have work to do.
I think the youngster looks a little wan, either from lack of the right foods or insufficient exercise, and there don't seem to be others his age he could pal around with.
Yep, doesn't seem to be.
I believe this room shows that this was, in fact, a sleeper ship, Captain. Notice the beds. They appear to be in general use now, but show every evidence of being cryo-sleep pods initially.
Well, these people woken up by their cryostasis and before they were supposed to? Their minds taken over us partially or something.
As institutionalized as this room appears, Captain, you can see people have done a few things to make it more their own. I wouldn't be surprised if people stash trinkets away. Things that have use and meaning to no one but them. Then again, I am definitely not going to suggest we go looking. Some of these beds don't appear to have been changed in longer than I want to think about. However, if someone wants to show us one of their little treasure boxes, I'll bet it's been well hidden.
Well, there's not a lot to look at.
Captain, I'm getting an anomalous reading. And now it reads as any ordinary door of dimensions common for any human-sized race. The anomaly was too brief to analyze.
Is it not really a door?
A young individual, apparently slightly underweight for his age norm. This individual appears to be typical of his race, perhaps somewhat elderly.
Captain Kirk is not...
So... there's really nothing to look at besides these two people and the doors that I can see.
This individual is a bit elderly, but not in too bad shape when you take that into account. He seems...
same description as before. It's the same person.
This individual is a juvenile in good condition, although mildly undernourished. There's no immediate danger, but there's some traits that should be watched. He's healthy now, both mentally and physically, but he's at some risk if he's put under too much stress.
Let me see that again so we can read along. McCoy seems to be ad-libbing his lines here.
This individual is a juvenile in good condition, although mildly undernourished. There's no immediate danger, but there's some traits that should be watched.
Phobic or bipolar disorders.
He's healthy now, both mentally and physically, but he's at some risk if he's put under too much stress.
Well, let's try not to put him under stress.
The elderly alien barely opens his eyes to glance at you, then closes them and lies back.
We were sleeping. The rigors of rulership are severe. Present yourselves if you must, else let me be.
Nah.
Hi there, I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. Who are you?
I'm Stan Bob.
Stan Bob.
Did my mom say I could talk to you?
Why, yes, she did. What can you tell us about things going on here?
Where's his mom?
No, not exactly. We'd like to know what you can tell us about things going on here, though. I don't know that we've seen your mother. Still, if you can tell us something about what's going on here, we would appreciate knowing it. Why, yes, she did. I don't know that we've seen your...
I don't think my mom would want me to talk to you. Please go away and stop bothering me.
Huh. Well, I never.
Why, there, remember me?
I don't think I should talk to you.
Maybe we should have lied to him after all? Want this?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Do you want this?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Shake him. Hi.
The elderly alien blinks as he awakens and then scowls furiously.
You, oops. The jumped up merchant.
Jumped up merchant.
Again. And your queenly dark companion? Speak up, my lady. Why are you not guarding the royal throne?
Your most puissant majesty. I left the throne warded by the royal guardian, Confucius, who will not permit the unworthy to sit there. Without first establishing the quality of their bloodlines and noble privileges.
Well, she said Confuju, and it says Kunjufu. Guarded. Okay, lying.
As a queen in my own right, I do not act according to your wishes. However nobly inspired, my royal brother, I'm sure you understand. Your most puissant majesty. As a queen in my own right, I do not act according to your wishes.
The elderly alien looks slightly puzzled.
For one who has such a queenly bearing, you have been ill-schooled in the true meaning and importance of duty. You gave your word to appear, and that is not to be lightly broken. We are disappointed and declare your noble claims tainted. We know duty and have our own duties to attend to elsewhere now. Goodbye.
Nah. Huh? Do I lose points for that? Can we get this? His blanket?
You notice that the coarse weave of the blanket is a bit scratchy, but it feels like it would be thick and warm.
Well, maybe that's what we're supposed to do so we can get his blanket. Wait, I don't have it. Oh wait, there it is. Now it's blue!
A somewhat small greenish-blue blanket.
Greenish-blue. Well, that would explain why it's green and then blue. What's this?
Captain Kirk is not...
Oh, never mind. Well...
don't think I should talk to you.
Well, what about Bones? Can you talk to him?
I don't think I should talk to you.
What about the pretty lady?
I don't think I...
Was that Bones?
I don't think...
This is Bones.
I don't think...
Alright, doesn't think you should talk to him. Would you like a blanket? You look cold.
I'm not going to talk to you.
Well, it wasn't involving talking, I was trying to give you that thing. Alright, guess we're done in here. Just in case I screwed up.
Save new game.
Let's save a new game. Let's see if we can go through this door that's possibly not actually a door.
Get back! I don't recognize you, you strangers! Rakaback, Gormagon!
Rakaback.
You recognize these people?
No, Tuskin, we sure don't.
Keep them away.
Tuskin!
Keep them away from me! They'll hurt us! They're out to get us, I tell you. Have I ever been wrong?
No, Tuskin, you kept us safe, and we keep you safe. We won't let him get you.
You people don't want to come any closer. Honest, I don't want to have to hurt any of you. It's just that Tuskin won't like it. I hope you don't mind, but you really have got to stay back.
Protect me. They're after me.
We'll hurt you, so just stay back.
We're standing here.
We really don't want to hurt you, you know, but you got to stay back.
We're staying back. Klingons.
See here, Captain Claw. I told you those Federation scum would be nosing around behind our backs.
The Klingon observers seem interested in remaining to watch what goes on here.
We're supposed to investigate uninterrupted behind your backs. You think this is all about you?
The captain seems most concerned with watching all the individuals in this room to be prepared for how they might react.
We ended up attacking the Klingons and vice versa.
Mr. Spock raises an eyebrow upon seeing this room is equipped with a 3D chess set, but quickly draws his attention back to matters at hand.
He's got an eye for those, huh?
The lieutenant is making judgments about the other individuals in the room, finding some threatening and others interesting. Dr. McCoy thinks that this room doesn't look like a very good place to kick back and relax, especially under the present circumstances.
True that.
A Klingon officer whose direct and intense expression never wavers. A Klingon crewman wearing a look of disdain and distrust.
A teddy bear.
A fuzzy animal-shaped toy that looks a bit like a bear.
More than a bit.
You like chess? Any good? Jake sees a whiz at it, even though he's pretty slow about everything else. My brother Rakaback took away his stuffed bear. Jakesy won't come in here to play no more. This is my greatest game ever. I'll give you the bear if you can beat me.
Yeah, you can have the dumb bear if you beat my brother at chess, and if you don't cheat.
Okay, all in good time.
A pillow. A room which appears to be dedicated to leisure and recreational activities. At least that's what you can see past the crowd of people. A room which appears to be an overturned toy box. A room which appears to be a room which this appears to be an unusual metallic structure. A dumbbell, a device used for muscular development.
That's what it's used for.
Pieces of wood and plastic. They were originally part of a toy. A simple sliding door. A room which appears to...
Okay.
An overturned toy box.
We looked at that.
A room which...
Looks like some kind of doll, like, curled up or something.
Save new game. Replace pre...
Let's analyze stuff. Actually, let's look at them first.
Gormagon is a large person with a slightly cowed and uneasy expression.
Gormagon.
He bears a strong familial resemblance to Rakaback, but gives the impression of somewhat more intelligence. Rakaback is a large individual with a somewhat dull-minded expression, but wary and distrustful. He bears a strong familial resemblance to Gormagon, who is standing close by.
Well, they're probably brothers.
Tuskin is a rather mangy-looking individual of middle age.
Maybe twins.
His hair is wildly disordered and his eyes wide and wary. He seems skittish and likely to burst into flight or fight mode at the smallest incentive.
Yeah, I'm getting that impression.
A lightweight plastic construction for a three-level chess-like game.
Hmm.
A large, irregular animal form construction, evidently used as a toy. Component materials include woven and pulp plant fiber and extruded plastics.
Kind of love this breakdown analysis of a teddy bear.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain. Nothing unusual.
Nothing unusual.
Nothing unusual. Captain, I'm getting a thoroughly anomalous reading. This passage definitely defies the physical laws of space and time.
Are you suggesting really? It might be some kind of space warping portal, Spock?
I am reluctant to speculate without data, Captain. I've never seen anything quite like this. The doors on this ship have given previous evidence of this kind of warping. Although the passages on this ship seem normal, they appear to curve space without resorting to hyperspace generation, like the Enterprise's engines.
Oh, damn.
That represents achievements of technology beyond our own abilities.
They certainly aren't as capable in the field of medicine. These people are suffering from genetic and chemical conditions that we've been able to treat for the last century. It's barbarous to pack them into this ill-conceived generation ship and hope by the time they make the return trip that those left behind will have figured out something more humane to do with them.
Captain, if I may interject, that disparity is something we glimpsed throughout this ship.
I was thinking the same thing myself, Lieutenant. I'd like to have a talk with whoever is behind this.
And I also, Captain Kirk. I believe our observations have been as anomalous as yours. Moreover, I don't think the Vays are the ones we must address our questions to.
Yeah, no one asked you. Notice how he just killed the conversation. Did I analyze everything yet? I think so.
Nothing unusual about... Nothing unusual.
Alright, let's talk amongst ourselves.
I must admit I've met friendlier people, Bones.
Drug therapy. Primitive 21st century medicine. The people who built this ship must have thought that filling a person's bloodstream with chemicals could solve every medical problem.
Maybe.
Captain, that chess game is fascinating.
Captain Tuskin bullies everyone. I think he's afraid of everyone, and that includes us. We should find a way to calm him down, I think. There must be some practical way. Perhaps we just need to see how he reacts to things, and then we can make a plan.
This Tuskin seems paranoid, trying to control everything. He's got a great fear of anyone fooling around with his mind. If he were a crew member, I'd suggest tranquilizers and a lot of examinations.
Before I talk to these dangerous
Save
people.
Game. Replace previous game.
Captain Kirk, dealing with Tuskin should be your first priority.
What are you gonna do?
You want help from me? That's a laugh. My captain evidently regards you rather highly, though. I'll just say that Rakaback rogue is clearly asking for a drubbing. I knew someone just like him back in basic training.
A drubbing, huh?
I listened to my brother Rackaback, and to my friend Tuskin. They say we have to protect this room and keep anyone from getting into it. Tuskin's afraid.
Watch what you say, Cormacon. You know I trust you.
He's just afraid, that's all.
Huh. He doesn't want... Tuskin doesn't want him saying what he's afraid about.
I'm more interested in a good fight than in talking.
Great.
I don't care who you say you are. You're evil monsters in disguise. You want to get by me and the only people I can trust.
That's right.
You want to get into the back of my brain. You want to rewire me and change the way I think.
That's fine.
Go away. Go away. Go away. Or we'll hurt you and make you go away.
I get the distinct impression you want us to go away.
Save new replace pre.
Resave.
I don't want to fight you. Got no reason to.
Are you out of your gourd, Jim? That hulking brute will rip your limbs off.
Just want to see what happens.
Violence is not the correct answer to this problem, Captain.
I wasn't using my phaser.
Captain, I think there must be some other way to achieve what we're trying to do here. I can be quick and charming, Captain, but I don't believe I can take on this big fellow.
Nope.
I don't think I can take him, Captain.
I don't think I can take him.
Looks too healthy for me to be willing to cross him. Looks more healthy than most of these folks, Jim. Let's just say I don't care to get into a dust-up with him.
Mm-hmm.
This individual appears quite disturbed and agitated.
You watch your mouth! You're trying to rile up my buddies, make everybody turn against me!
Mm-hmm. Let's have him analyze.
Gormagon is one of the healthier individuals on this ship. Except for emotional stress, probably the result of being bullied by his buddies here. He's reasonably sound in mind and body. If I had to, I'd feel confident about treating him medically.
What'd he say at the end? He keeps ad-libbing his lines. Seems that way anyway.
Gormagon is one of the healthier individuals on
this
ship.
Like anyone else I've seen on this ship.
Like so many others aboard this ship, he's the victim of developmental genetic damage. A chromosomal misalignment induces a greater inclination to violence. I wouldn't feel confident enough to treat him medically without the full database of the Enterprise systems.
Assisting in the analysis.
Jim, he has fairly extensive brain damage and may be causing paranoid delusions. It's also resulting in increased levels of hostility. His adrenaline levels run quite high, and there's been organ damage from the extreme stress.
Produced by what?
Jim, he has fairly extensive brain damage and may...
Produced by his state of mind. We keep cutting off.
Keep away from me. I don't need that. I don't want to hurt you, but I won't let you hurt me neither.
Captain, I don't think this is a smart thing for me to be doing.
Internal error. Not found. Tox anim. Game aborted. Well, good thing I've been saving.